Hi guys, it's Valerie here with today's trailer and what's hot in movie news. Enjoy today's trailer and then stick around for news on Justice League. Shot
where every single hero on the team comes together and they finally fight as a team.
The great thing about the tie-in shot where all the Avengers are working together to battle the aliens is that it used four different virtual New York locations that we had to tie in together as Iron Man's flying between them.
From the day that we saw the previs for this shot, we realized this was going to be a massive undertaking because it's a very long shot, no cuts, where we go from hero to hero and we fly around New York, seeing how they're fighting off the alien horde. In some cases, you know, we've got an actor on a set, a partial set with blue screen behind them. But a lot of these characters were CG, like Iron Man and the Hulk, and all the aliens that they're fighting, of course, and New York was CG behind them.
We had two location leads that went around Manhattan, in both Midtown and Lower Manhattan, and filmed 1,200 different locations that allowed us to build up our virtual New York. Those images are then stitched together to create what people are usually referred to as a panosphere or panoramic image of that location.
We can fly and go anywhere we want through New York. We can fly Iron Man down the streets. We can have Scarlett flying on the chariot. So we had to sort of choreograph with the director what it was he wanted to see in the shot and the flight path and the action with what spheres we had that could support that action.
One of the challenges was Captain America. They had shot an element of Captain America on set, but when we got down to the final shot, we realized this shot is about showing the Avengers coming together and finally working as a team. So we had an opportunity when Iron Man flew in next to Captain America to show not only that they're just fighting around each other, but that they're helping each other and that they're trading off blows to kind of win as a team. And to do this, we realized we had to change Captain America's motions, which meant that that went from, you know, a blue screen plate of Captain America to an all digital human. And so luckily we had taken our Captain America digital double to a point where that could be done. So because the shot was so massive, we had to break it into sections so that we could give each section to separate groups of artists and work on them as though they were a single shot. And then we had a separate team whose job it was to pull all those sections back together and make a cohesive shot out of it. And making sure that at the blend points, that it still worked, that it worked as a cohesive shot and that it all felt like the same shot all the time.
There are a lot of things riding on Warner Brothers and DC Comics' upcoming Justice League movie. A big part of that includes what characters should be in the League, like Superman, Batman, Green Lantern, Wonder Woman, Aquaman, The Flash, and what story should be told. On the other side, there is also the question on who should be the villain. Sources reveal that it will be the arch-villain Darkseid. Will Bill is writing Justice League, and it will be interesting to see how he incorporates so many superhero origins with one of the most evil villains. Justice League will be in theaters in 2015. What do you think about Justice League? Let us know below. Thanks for watching. Remember to like us on Facebook. See you next time.